Broncos take the field on the blue for the first time here in 2019. And we got an interesting matchup for you. These fans are so excited to see their team at home for the first time after what happened in week one. Marshall and Boise State, our matchup here from Boise. This place still buzzing after the win in Tallahassee.
Here's the snap. They send it to the blitz, picked up nicely. There's a pass downfield. Looking down, they're going to receive it in the air. Hit it a couple. Touchdown, Keyshawn Helton.
Bachmeier, right corner of the end zone. Shakir leaps. Shakir makes the catch. Bachmeier, Mahone up the middle, spinning. Touchdown. Boise State has surged into the lead.
And this one's going to go in the win column for the Broncos. 36-31 over Florida State. Unbelievable.
There have been a lot of big wins in the history of this Broncos program, but that one was one of the bigger ones, and now we'll see if they can back it up. Marshall on the road to take on the number 24-ranked Broncos, whose head coach is down on the blue with our own Paul Carpetero.
Coach, another home opener. What gives you the confidence that your true freshman quarterback, Hank Bachmeier, can step up and embrace this moment?
Well, we're going to find out. I think his preparation, the work he's put in, and the experience he took away from last game. We'll see how it applies to this one.
Marshall brings back 9 starters on offense. Where will they challenge your defense the most tonight?
Well, I think all over. They got experience on the offensive side. They can run the ball. They can throw it. The quarterback's dynamic. So we got to go out there and play complete on defense. Communicate to each other. Just get to the ball.
Thank you, Coach.
Thank you.
All right, Paul, thanks very much. And there are the thundering herd of Marshall getting ready to take the field. They're feeling like this is a chance for a program-changing win. Kickoff coming up next after a short break. We'll be back to Boise. I think you could argue that the biggest story in college football week one was the performance of the freshman quarterbacks. Bo Nix and Auburn with their dramatic win against the Oregon Ducks. And he wasn't the only one. Sam Howell in North Carolina, Mac Brown's first game back at Carolina. 2 long touchdown drives late. And then Hank Bachmeier, the kid that we just heard about here at Boise State. He's going to play at home for the first time tonight. He was so impressive in Tallahassee, beating Florida State. And that win has these Broncos fans geared up for what they think could be a very special season. Dave Fleming, Jim Moore, great to have you with us here on Friday night. Hank was great. The numbers were great, but you were really impressed by the toughness.
I thought he showed unusual poise and toughness for a true freshman, really for any player. To stand in there and get clobbered the way that he did early and have the wherewithal to keep his wits about him and deliver some key throws for first downs, for touchdowns, to keep drives alive. Here you see him drifting to his right. His helmet's coming off. He throws a 3rd-and-10 ball down the sidelines for a first down after he'd been sacked the play before. So you're talking about a young man that is just very mature for a true freshman quarterback.
And the numbers backed up that toughness. 30 completions, 400-plus yards with a touchdown pass on the road against Florida State. And we'll see tonight how he backs it up. The first home game for young Hank Bachmeier and Boise State. And with kickoff about to happen, we'll have to wait a little while for Hank and the Broncos to get the ball because Marshall won the toss and they will receive. Willie Johnson is back deep in kickoff return formation for the first time on the blue here in 2019. They think it could be a very special Boise State football season. And Johnson's going to bring the ball out on the kickoff return. He's got some burst and gets it close to the 25-yard line. So now the Marshall offense will take the field for the first time. Isaiah Green not tested quite the same way that Bachmeier was against Florida State. Marshall played VMI in week one, but this is a kid who's got some talent.
No, I think he's a really good young quarterback. He's grown up playing last year. He's a dual threat type guy. They don't like to run him a lot, but they will run him. And Doc Holliday told us, you know, the game slows down for this young man as the pressure increases. So I'm excited to see him against a really good Boise State defense.
Well, Marshall may be the best team in Conference USA, and they have built this game up to be a very big deal. We'll see. A little quick hitter completion on the right side for a short gain to Tyler King, one of their dynamic running backs. They'll look to get the ball to Tyler King quite a bit. And one guy that the offense of Marshall will have to account for is number 99, Curtis Weaver.
This is an outstanding player. They'll move him around. They'll play him at defensive end. They'll play him at their stud linebacker, which means he's into the boundary, which is where he is now. He's best when he's rushing the passer.
21 and a half career sacks for Curtis Weaver on second down, and another open target and another nice delivery for a first down.
I think when you go on the road, it's important to give your quarterback easy, quick throws early. Get him in a rhythm. Let him gain some confidence. This is not an easy environment to play in, and that's what you've seen in the first two plays. Two throws into the boundary, quick, get some yards, move the sticks.
Yeah, there is definitely a confidence on that Marshall sideline that they can move the ball. That's not to say Boise State doesn't have talented defensive players. Plenty of time on the play clock. Green under center on first down. Going to hand the ball off for the first time. Not a lot of room there. And Tyler King driven backwards.
What you saw King do there is he comes up and he did something he wouldn't have done last year, and that's take command of the offense, change the play, try to get him into the right play. It didn't work out right there, but that is just a sign of his maturity as a quarterback. It's also a sign of the coaching staff's confidence in him at the line of scrimmage.
So Green on second down, and Marshall believes that they will have to run the ball quite a bit tonight against Boise State. They're going to hand it off for a second straight time, and that's a nice gain up the middle. Brendan Knox, and he may be a little more powerful than Tyler King, who had that first carry.
They've got two really good running backs, a little bit different in style. But, you know, King probably a little bit more shifty. Knox is a little bit more of a hammer. Gets him into third and four. You're on the road early. You want to get yourself into third and manageable.
Boise State fans, first time this season on a third down, making some noise. Marshall, quarterback pressure to that completion. I don't know that he got there. It's close, but I'm not sure all the way. I don't think he did.
He's short. It's interesting for old Doc Holliday. You want to make a statement early in the game and go for it, or are you going to play it safe and punt it away? I'd punt it away.
I'm not sure that Doc agrees with you. Maybe he does. Yeah. All right.
Your own in, first drive, freshman quarterback on the other side. Let's put him down in there deep.
Robert Lefevre, who is a good player. Marshall's got good special teams. Part of the field where you could have at least thought about some sort of special teams trick play. That's an excellent punt. So if you're going to punt it and not go for it, you're leaning on your punter to get a good kickoff, and he did.
He did a great job. He's one of those rugby punters, rolls out to his right, kicks it back to his left. Avery Williams never had a chance to even field that ball, so they start on the 7-yard line.
49 yards, no return. And so, for the first time on the blue turf, you know he's been thinking about this a lot. True freshman quarterback Hank Bachmeier, off his incredibly impressive performance last week against Florida State. And it's not just Hank who's been anxious for this. After watching that game,
I've been anxious.
Everybody in this town has looked forward to seeing him play here at home for the first time. A true freshman, Robert Mahone, who also had a terrific game. All alone in the backfield, and Mahone's going to get the carry on first down. Marshall right there.
That's a good start for the Marshall defense. One of the concerns is the size mismatch between the Boise State offensive line and the front seven for Marshall. So you're going to see some movement up front. You're going to see some different alignments up front, and that's a good start.
Boise State having to rework their offensive line just a little bit. John Ajukwu, the right tackle, talented kid, hurt and out for at least a couple weeks. For Boise State on second and nine. Bachmeier will swing it out. Just a little quick hitter to the left side for a positive game, but that hustling Marshall defense right there.
Well, Marshall, I love to watch Marshall play defense. Now, they may be a little bit undersized, but they're extremely athletic, and they love to play the game. And when you watch the film, their passion for football, it jumps off the screen. You talk about defensive linemen getting out of the stack and running the ball down. Looks like all 11 guys are pulled by a string.
There's the difference size-wise on the offensive line for Boise State, the defensive line for Marshall. They're down at six. Bachmeier has a nice pocket, and he'll throw with a receiver wide open for a first down and more. I think that's Garrett Collingham, the tight end, outside the 30.
You'll see here, Marshall really only brings 3-4 with the inside linebacker, but they vacate a zone. And Hank has time to stand in there, something he didn't have last week. But what you see there is that Hank understands concept, and he has great field vision.
So a third down conversion, and now some breathing room with much better field position. That was a 22-yard gain. First home drive of the year for the Broncos, shifting all kinds of places. And now two in the backfield. A handoff straight ahead running. And that's Khalil Shakir, who is a wide receiver, getting a carry for a short gain. Well, Jim, you mentioned it, the hits that Bachmeier had to endure last week. He took 28 hits in week one. Just for a comparison, two quarterbacks who don't get hit a lot in the NFL, that's last season, the full season. Drew Brees got hit 34 times. Hank got hit 28 times at Florida State. And if you talk to the Boise State people, it's like he got better with every hit that he took. That was a nice play to create some time and get the ball out to the right flat for a first down.
This is a key developmental point for a young quarterback. Hank is able to keep his eyes up. I mean, watch his vision field. Keeps his eyes up as he works to avoid pressure. You mentioned Drew Brees a minute ago. He looked like Drew Brees there, working in the pocket and finding the throwing lane and then going out to his check down in the flat. That's a mature young man right there.
I will say this about it. This is not a criticism at all. This is just a point to say he is mature. He's 20 years old. Handoff for a nice gain for Robert Mahone. So he is a true freshman, and it's a huge difference playing at Murrieta Valley High School and here against Florida State or Marshall at the D1 level. But that extra year, year and a half of maturity, I think is paying off on the field.
It makes a big difference, that year and a half, that year. It also makes a big difference that he had to go down to Tallahassee last week and play against a great Florida State defense. Now he gets to come back to the comforts of home. And so far, they've protected well for him.
Play fake on second down. He is pressured here, takes a hit, and throws it into coverage. Incomplete. Well, the first time that Channing Haynes, who's a good player up front for Marshall, got in on the quarterback.
You'll see Channing Haynes move all over. This guy's a really dynamic pass rusher, and he beats the left tackle there, and that's just a good hit on Hank. But one thing that you saw against Bob Bachmeier, jumps right up, looks down the field. He's ready for the next play.
The next play is third and six from near midfield. Let that clock wind. On the move, that throw short and a great open field tackle. Well short of the first down. So Tavante Beckett makes sure that the Broncos are going to have to punt.
That's a good start for the Marshall defense. Now, you know, a couple good completions, second down completion by Bachmeier there, where they vacated the zone. But to get off the field on third down on the Broncos end of the field, I think they'll take that as a win.
So the punt return specialist, Talik Keaton, who had a touchdown in his first game in that role last week. He's got some speed back there. Marshall has a lot of team speed. Fair catch signal made. And inside the 10-yard line. Well, the field got flipped there, at least by the Broncos. Flipping the fly rod out in the Boise River. What a scene.
She needs to raise that elbow a little bit. So.
No score. Back right after this.
ESPN College Football, brought to you by AutoZone. Get in the zone.
Well, it was just a couple days ago, a group of folks who are going to literally bike coast to coast for cancer stopped here in Boise, Idaho, on their way to the East Coast, raising money for cancer research. Check it out, cancerbikeride.org, if you want to find out more on this beautiful night in Idaho. Boise State at home for the first time, and the Marshall offense on the field for the second drive of the game for them. Brendan Knox with the carry, gain of two on first down. Kekoa Nawahine, one of the leading tacklers for the Broncos.
Let's keep an eye here on number 11, Xavier Gaines, who's listed as a tight end, but he's built a little bit more like a big NFL wide receiver. You know, he's a Dez Bryant type athlete that can do a lot of things. Let's see if they try to get him isolated.
He's sort of in that tight end H-back formation on the left side. Green, the quarterback's going to throw to nobody. Intended for Willie Johnson, but Willie went in a different direction. It's third and nine from a part of the field where you wonder how aggressive Marshall is going to be.
Well, you've got a quarterback that you've got some confidence in. You gain some confidence in your receivers that were young and inexperienced and really untested last week versus VMI. So I think they'll be aggressive here. I think they've got to try to get some first downs and get the ball out of here.
Big test for Marshall on the road here tonight. But unquestionably one of the best teams from Conference USA. Pressured, Green delivers right on the money, and that slant with the run after catch is going to get Marshall a first down. Artie Henry with the catch and run.
You're going to see their tight end, Levias, right here come out and block. You get the great block on the inside or the outside. And really, you know, that's not an aggressive play, but it's a safe play. You know, it's an easy throw. The receiver's running towards you. If they tackle you, you're punting it. If you got a little guy in space, you make that miss, you move the sticks like they did there.
Now, how about the guy you were just talking about? Xavier Gaines is in the backfield to take a direct snap. Tight end, high school quarterback. And he's going to hand the ball off. Maybe he should have kept it.
Yeah. You know, it's always fun to take an athlete like that who was a high school quarterback who could do so many things and put him in different spots. But you run a zone read with a guy that hasn't done it a lot. And he had a lane. I mean, he had a lane, but he handed it off. And we're not going to see him just hand it off every time he's back there tonight. This guy, he can throw it, he can run it, he can catch it, he can do a lot. I don't know, maybe he can kick it. I don't know. He can do a lot of things.
Well, he is a guy to watch. He's an interesting player.
Well, he's in the backfield again.
He's a big-time high school recruit. Ended up at Marshall. And Isaiah Green, the quarterback, is actually back there with Gaines. A little pitch play running laterally to the right with just nowhere to go. Track down Ezekiel Noah with the tackle. Well, one thing about this first quarter, it's moving. And for Marshall, maybe not the worst thing to shorten the game in a way.
This is a big third down. They've got to flip the field again. They were able to flip it after their first possession. They need to get a couple first downs and at least flip the field and make Boise State go the long way.
Oh. The Broncos team that didn't exactly like how that was setting up, so they decided to use a timeout. So the Broncos want to get organized on defense. Big play coming when we come back here to Boise. Well, why wouldn't you kick off the first NFL Sunday of the year with Sunday NFL Countdown 10 Eastern right on ESPN, streaming live on the app. So much to talk about, including Randy Moss picking this week's best catches from college football in You Got Moss. And speaking of the great Randy Moss, I mean, they've had a lot of great players at Marshall, but to me, there's no question who the greatest is. It was man against boys. It was not fair.
Well, it was man against boys in the NFL at times as well. I had to try to defend that guy a lot.
Yeah.
How'd that go? It didn't go well. You see where I'm at? In the booth.
Yeah.
Didn't go well.
I'm looking for Randy down on the field for this third down play. I'm not seeing number 88 out there for Marshall. Third and 10 from inside their own 20-yard line. Just under 5 minutes to go in quarter number one. Dave Fleming, Jim Mora, Paul Carcaterra, and a fake with the quarterback keep. And Green, who's got that speed. That was a nice move. He took a big hit and gets shoved out of bounds. And somebody else on the sideline hopefully is okay, because a coach or someone over there took a big hit himself. But Isaiah Green pops up. That's a first down, Marshall.
This is a nice-looking play into the boundary on Weaver. So they get Weaver to squeeze down on King, and all of a sudden you've got Green in a race to the first down marker, and he wins it.
So that's a big conversion. They've already converted a third and nine and a third and 10 on this drive after starting inside their own 10. They will get the ball on the outside to Tyler King. Well, the ball came out. Extra effort. I don't think they blew the whistle. Now Boise State should have recovered that one. The question is, did they? If they didn't, that would be some shades of last week in Florida State, but they did. They pounced on the ball, and a turnover with Tyler King trying to get a little extra yardage at the end of the play. The ball came out.
Watch the tackle here by Nawahini up under the chin. Once he secures the tackle, everybody else comes in and goes after the ball. You watch Weaver trying to rip it out. That's a big play. Marshall's done a really good job of controlling the clock, controlling field position, and they turn it over here in their own territory.
I think Tyreek Jones was the guy who ended up falling on the ball. There were just for a moment there were shades of that big play down close to the goal line where Florida State should have come up with a fumble, didn't, and Boise State ended up scoring.
Let's see if they take a shot.
They might. Hank Bachmeier back on the field looking for his first home touchdown pass of his Boise State career. Instead, it's a little pitch play. Well defended, Mahone. Maybe a yard, maybe. Robert Mahone with the big gain, big game against Florida State. So far, not a lot of running room against this Marshall defense.
No, and Coach Harsin talked about trying to push the perimeter, run the ball outside, try to make the corners and safeties from Marshall make tackles. But so far, they're not getting to the second level with their outside runs.
Oh, Boise quickly to the line, and they'll snap it quickly, hand it off to Mahone again, trying to find some room. And again, there's just no room whatsoever on the outside. Strung out, and Mahone tossed onto the Marshall side.
Well, you know, this Marshall defense might be undersized, but as I've said, they can really run. They play square. They play with discipline. They play fast, and they're really good tacklers. One thing that really stood out to me on film, you know, week one, you see a lot of poor tackling in college football. You didn't see that much out of this Marshall defense when you watch the tape.
When the snot's hanging from the face mask, you know they're playing hard. And it was third and nine. Kind of borderline field goal range, and maybe not for Boise State.
Well, they're gonna bring a linebacker here.
Let's see. Bachmeier throws, and a man wide open. He missed him. He took a hit. Khalil Shakir was all alone. All alone.
Now this is just absolutely a busted coverage. That's an understatement. But the hit, you know, these hits, they start to accumulate. And I don't care who you are. And you can see here what happens on the hit is actually his release is affected. And that's why that ball soars there.
Yeah, the arm got hit, and maybe that saved the touchdown for Marshall. So Eric Sachs, who had a great game last week at Tallahassee, his first game with Boise State, his kick is up, and it drifts to the right. No good. So the first miss of his Boise State career from 49 yards. And the Marshall defense, after giving up the turnover, the Marshall offense put their defense in a bad spot, and the defense stepped up. So Eric Sachs, who was a cult hero last week, first try at home, no good.
Welcome back to the Blue in Boise, Idaho. And so much talk about freshman quarterback for Boise State, Hank Bachmeier. How about Isaiah Green for Marshall? He's a sophomore, but as a freshman a year ago, put up some serious numbers. And you got to watch him as a runner. He does not want to be known as a dual-threat quarterback. When things break down, though, he can really get it going. I spoke to him last year. He told me he wants to play like Patrick Mahomes, improv when the pocket breaks down. Who doesn't want to play like Patrick Mahomes?
I believe every quarterback in the country would like to play like Patrick Mahomes these days. Isaiah Green handed it off to Brendan Knox for a nice gain on first down. It's second and one Marshall after their defense came up with an impressive stop. Running the ball on second down to get the first. Well, Marshall's offense, I mean, the turnover was a problem, but so far they have been able to move the ball.
They've moved the ball. They've controlled the clock. They've done a nice job with field position. Their defense went out after the turnover, got them the ball back right away. This is a very, very good start for Marshall on the road against, you know, what most people feel is probably a superior Boise State team, but it doesn't look like it at this point.
2 minutes to go in the first quarter. And so far, still nothing, nothing. With a play fake, and Green flips it down the right sideline. There is Xavier Gaines for a big gain. Got upended at the end of it, but inside the 35, all the way down to the 30.
That's a good-looking play. You get a tight end running a wheel route up the sideline, matched up on a linebacker, and they just lose track of him.
Well, it's easy to do. So far, he's lined up as a tight end, a slot receiver, a wide receiver, a quarterback, and a running back.
It's like, where's Waldo?
It's hard to find him. And they couldn't there. Hand off. And a big hole on the left side, straight up the middle. Brendan Knox inside the 15. Not quite first and goal, but another big gain for the Thundering Herd.
Coach Holliday talked about being able to run the football. You see how they get a nice crack block there, but they seal the edge. They get Knox into the open field, and this guy's a hard runner. He's a fall forward type of runner.
They may not be quite as big as Boise State, but they've got experience on their offensive line. It's a good unit. Knox gets another carry and a burst into the end zone for a touchdown. Brendan Knox has put Marshall ahead. 13-yard touchdown run. That was impressive. Marshall's come to play tonight. And I know it's just the first quarter, but there is some concern on the fans of those Boise State Broncos in the stands here about what kind of challenge their team has, because Marshall has announced that they are going to be a challenge.
Well, Boise State can't let Marshall get their neck up on the run. They can't let them establish a run early. That series, after the great stop by their defense, I believe it was four runs and then pass up the sideline to Gaines. That's what you want to do on the road.
The run was beautiful. The point after wasn't that pretty, but it counted. And the Thundering Herd take a 7-0 lead. Well, some can't-miss college football. A doubleheader on ABC this Saturday. Number one Clemson hosting Texas A&M. That has a chance to be a great game. 3:30 Eastern on ABC. And then the headliner, LSU goes into Austin to take on a top 10 Texas team. We'll see how good the Longhorns are, because I think we know LSU's pretty good. 7:30 Eastern on Saturday. Also on ABC, that is tomorrow, with a full day of college football. Marshall with the first touchdown of this game. Boise State is going to bring the kick back, and John Hightower's got room. Hightower across the 35, close to the 40 for a nice kick return for Boise State. Let's go downstairs to Paul Carcaterra.
You know, we talk about Hank Buckmeyer and his toughness drilled 28 times a week ago down in Tallahassee. When I spoke to co-offensive coordinator Eric Keesaw, I said the first few times he was a little worried about the freshman coming off the field. How would he react? What would his body language be like? And he said he was so cool. He would clap his hands. He'd say, "Let's go, coach. What's going on?" And when you think about his upbringing, guys, he's got brothers in his house. Their names are Buck, Tiger, and Bear. How can you not be tough with brothers with names like that?
Now, I like the name Hank, but I, you know, which one is not like the others? What happened? We got a little more creative after Hank, or what? Time to throw. Deep ball down the left sideline. And incomplete. Hightower, who's got speed, close, just out of his reach.
I love the play call. You get a big return following a touchdown, you take a shot, and that, you know what? That ball should be caught now. You got to lay out, you got to leave your feet, and you got to make a big play for your freshman quarterback when you're down 7-0.
You know, sometimes I think you're the guy who had the kick return. Hightower was.
He's a little winded.
Maybe a little bit.
Maybe he didn't have that step he needed to go get that. That's a good receiver.
Second down. Under a minute to go, first quarter in Boise State. Not that they're shocked by this, but having to play from behind. That pass high, but caught by Octavius Evans to set up third down.
Well, there's two clean pockets for Hank, so maybe, you know, they're settling down a little bit. They maxed it up on that first throw, took a deep shot, and then they came back with a quick throw.
Yeah, and Clark talked about the hits, but at one point that you've already made in this first quarter, it's great to say, yeah, he popped up and he hung in there. At some point,
yep,
those hits start to take their toll. I don't care who your quarterback is.
No, they do. They do. You get bruised, you get battered.
Third and five. Short drop, and that throw over the top, back shoulder. Did he get the foot down? Yes. Khalil Shakir, who looks like he's turning into a big time playmaker. That's a first down.
I love the throw here. You got a press corner into the boundary. That's the slow old slot fade. You take the inside receiver and you run the fade route. That's a really tough ball to defend for a defensive back, because we're in good position there. Gilmore's in position, but the ball is thrown away from him. He just can't get to it.
You're spoken like a former defensive back. That's hard to guard.
That's hard to guard.
So the 20-yard completion for a first down, but not everything going just swimmingly for the Broncos of Boise State, because Marshall's got some playmakers, and the Thundering Herd have come on the road on the blue turf. And at the end of quarter number one, Marshall has the 7-0 lead. Well, UFC 242 is coming up on Saturday from, of all places, Abu Dhabi. It's a long way from Boise, Idaho. I don't need to tell you that Khabib Nurmagomedov is going to fight Dustin Poirier. Yeah, order at ESPNplus.com/PPV. First play of the second quarter. Boise State keeping the ball on the ground. So far, quiet game for Robert Mahone. Mahone, who just gashed the Florida State defense, especially in the second half. The running lanes haven't been there tonight.
Quiet game for the Boise State run game, which is something they need to establish, especially with a young quarterback. And against an undersized front, they're having trouble. But you're seeing some pre-snap movement. I think it's changing the blocking lanes and assignments for the offensive line and making it a little difficult.
A little double tight end look for Boise State. And even with that, just not anywhere for Mahone to go. He did surge forward and got 3, maybe 4 yards, but it's third down coming up. Marshall has not allowed a 100-yard rusher. Now, look, the schedule is a little different for the Thundering Herd, but still, that's impressive. November of 2017, it didn't happen one time last year against Marshall.
Well, they commit to stopping the run, and they're good at it, and they do a nice job up front moving in and out of odd and even fronts. They'll do it by alignment. They'll do it right before the ball snapped here or there in an odd look. Of course, it's third down. I'm sure they'll bring a little pressure.
Handing it off. Could be four down territory. Mahone broke one tackle, not a second, though. Inside the 30, it's fourth and two. My guess is if you call that play, you're thinking going for it on fourth down.
Yeah, they just brought extra tight ends. They brought their big people in. They've got three tight ends and a back, one wide receiver. And they called that play thinking if they don't get it, we're going for it on fourth down.
It's a big test here for the Marshall defense. And the big boys up front for Boise State. Shakir came in motion and a timeout, and it was not Marshall.
Timeout, Boise State. That's their second.
The Thundering Herd thought they were ready. Boise State wasn't so sure. So the timeout means we'll take one of our own. Fourth down coming up. Marshall with the touchdown lead. Two good experienced head coaches, Brian Harsin's sixth year at Boise State. Doc Holliday from the state of West Virginia, 10th year as the head coach at Marshall, has a chance to have one of his biggest wins. Boise State trying to back up one of Brian Harsin's biggest wins last week in Tallahassee against Florida State. 7-0 Marshall here early in the second quarter, and a fourth down play out of the timeout. Boise State going for it. They put Bachmeier in the shotgun, and he's going to throw the ball with some pressure coming. And Bachmeier will fling it up, incomplete. So Marshall brings pressure. Bachmeier goes down, and the Thundering Herd defense with another stop.
Marshall came after him here. I mean, they committed to stopping the run. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 guys up at the line of scrimmage here. And they were playing for the run, but they also had a little blitz on here. They got some angles, and they were able to get to Bachmeier. I'm going to tell you what, I don't like what Bachmeier did late there, throwing the football. Take the sack. Don't make the critical error, throwing the ball up when you're going down on your back and risk the interception. That right there, that's youth. That's something he's got to learn.
I mean, you can sort of understand, hey, it's fourth down. Let me just
unless it turns into a touchdown.
But
going
if it
the
goes
other way,
the other direction, that's not a good result.
Right.
So Gaines is going to take the direct snap for the second time in this game. And he will keep it this time. Gaines bounces to the left side and gets 9, close to 10 yards on first down. Well, they told us Xavier Gaines was going to be a playmaker for this Marshall team, and he has been.
He's a really good-looking athlete. He ran the zone read again. That time he kept it the first time he handed it off. And, you know, he's not a guy that you're looking forward to tackle if you're a defensive back. Big, physical, hard running. You know what he reminds me of? Physically, Terrell Owens. And he runs angry like T.O. used to run.
I mean, imagine if in college, T.O. had been allowed to do all these different things.
Well, he's going to throw it here soon.
He's taking another snap. He will hand it off on the right side in a big hole with blockers out in front. Across midfield for Tyler King. First down, Marshall. I mean, we told you he was a high school quarterback, and he was a good one. So we dug up some footage. He's got a strong arm. He was a highly recruited kid from the state of Florida. Throw the ball a little bit, and definitely an athlete who could run with all that size.
I think we're going to see him throw it at some point in this game. I think the zone read stuff is to pull Boise State's defense up. Eventually, they'll take a shot with Gaines throwing it.
Isaiah Green is in at quarterback this time. The handoff with much less running room. In fact, the tailback going backwards. Sonatane Louis led the way with the tackle. Curtis Weaver was there as well.
I like what Marshall is doing with Gaines. When they put Gaines in it at the quarterback spot, they leave Green on the field. So there's no indicator pre-snap or pre-alignment that Gaines is going to be at quarterback.
Second down and 11 right at midfield for Marshall. Right now, the Thundering Herd are controlling this game. I think the running back might have gone in the wrong direction. Green pressured, throws. That was a dangerous throw and a good hit. But hanging onto the ball, Talit Keaton for the positive gain. It's third down.
That's a tough throw, rolling out to your left, throwing it back inside. That's a dangerous throw. When they look at the film tomorrow or Sunday, that's when the coaches say, hey, look it. You know, I know what you saw, but let's not make that throw again. Worked out that time. Let's not do it again.
Third and eight. Boise's defense, they need to stop.
Well, you want to look at Weaver down here. They dropped him.
Instead, to the opposite side, and that ball knocked out. That was a dangerous pass. Again, looking for the redshirt freshman, Keaton. It's fourth down. Jalen Walker got his hand on the ball.
I like Jalen Walker. He's a good corner. And this play right here was reminiscent of the Florida State game. Talking to their coach, they said that the tide kind of turned on defense at Florida State when Jalen Walker came up on one of those little quick screens out there and made a really good play on the Florida State receiver. Maybe this sparks him on a little bit.
So fourth down. I would imagine the Broncos are going to be on high alert most of this game for some trick plays on special teams, because that's been a signature of Marshall's program for a while.
They take great pride in the way they play special teams.
Oh, it's just a regular old punt. End over end with the fair catch, but it's a good punt. Boise State will not have great field position when we come back. A beautiful day here in Boise. There's no football stadium in the country where you can catch a rainbow trout walking 50 yards off the blue turf like there is here in Idaho. Dave Fleming, Jim Moore back here in Boise. Now, I thought this was really cool. When you were the head coach at UCLA, Hank Bachmeier, not quite in your backyard, but in Southern California, highly recruited quarterback. He's a guy that you got to know when he was in high school. You recruited him.
We recruited him. We offered him in January of 2017. We found an old scouting report.
This was really impressive that you still had this.
And how about this evaluation by Matt Bernstein, our director of football operations, does a great job of extending plays within the pocket. But how about this? Will not be affected by pass rushers, and that's what we saw last week at Florida State, and I think that's what we're seeing so far today. But I think old Bernie was right on with that evaluation.
I think he was, and this kid has a chance to be really special. But tonight, so far, it has not been easy for the Broncos. They are not on the board yet, trailing 7-0. 10:25 to go in the first half, and a little flea flicker kind of play. Bachmeier buys time. He's going to air it out down the middle into coverage and incomplete. We still have not had a penalty called in this game. There was some contact there. They're letting him play.
They're letting him play. I like the play call, though. Let's take a shot.
A little hand on the jersey, then on the shoulder pad.
They got away with one right there.
I think
there.
They did. Jalen McClain sap. If the defensive coach says they got away with one, they really got away with one.
You know what, though? If they didn't call it, it didn't happen.
Am I wrong at that? We still have not had a penalty in this game.
We have not.
So second down, that throw. Ball wobbled out there a little bit, but the completion close to the 15.
Coach, I love that scouting report on Hank. And, you know, first impressions last a lifetime. Why don't you tell everyone how Hank showed up on a recruiting visit?
Hank used to show up in a sport coat, oftentimes a tie, very serious. You can see the look on his face right there. But often kids show up in T-shirts and shorts, and not Hank. Hank was always very professional.
Was he a 16, 17-year-old in that picture,
or something like that? Maybe 15 or 16, yeah.
Third and five for Bachmeier, the true freshman. He'll step up, and Bachmeyer, I think, is going to run. He took a hit there, spins, and gets the first down. Now, if he went into a slide, I'm not sure he gets it, so he wanted that first down.
One thing about Hank is he's got great awareness, and when he scrambles up the middle, you know, he'll remain a passer as long as he can. You watch him here. He keeps his eyes up. The rush doesn't affect him, but he knows that he has to tuck it, and he knows he has to drop his shoulder and really work to get the first down, because you're right, Dave. He slides there. They're probably punting.
First and 10, Boise State. Marshall's defense playing really well. George Helani, another true freshman. He had a big debut in Tallahassee last week. He's in the backfield. They're going to give it to Hightower, though. End around, and Hightower strung out. Got a couple yards, maybe.
Well, we said it earlier. You know, Coach Harson says, hey, we need to attack the edges. We need to make their DBs tackle. But that ball is not getting to the edge. I mean, it's Marshall, they're showing their team speed. Is what they're doing, and I really like the way that they play defense. They run.
4 yards per play for Boise State, only four first downs. This is a team that went up and down the field on the road against Florida State a week ago. Bachmeyer, quick release, and the tight end open in the flat. The open field tackle, though, John Bates stopped well short of a first down. It'll be another third down.
Devontae Beckett is a really good football player. He plays their weak inside linebacker position this week. He's undersized. He's about 209 pounds, but he is a physical football player. Look at the big old. He looks like an old-time guy with the big old neck roll right there. I'll tell you what, athletic young player.
Started his career at Virginia Tech. Now at Marshall, he's had a nice first half, third and four. We have not seen quick tempo from Boise State. No. We saw a lot of it against the Seminoles. Pressure immediately, and the quick hitter for a first down and more. Out into the open field. Penalty flag thrown behind the play. Akilian Butler down the right sideline, inside the 10 into the end zone. But is it coming back?
Well, it's coming back, but it'll be a first down. Great play call. Great play call by Zach Hill.
74 yards as of now, but Coach Harson knows with that flag sitting on the blue turf.
Offense, number 68. Jim Lockman from the spot of the foul.
That's Jake Stets. He is the replacement. Look out. And that's going to be a personal foul against Brian Harson. That you cannot do that. I don't know. We just saw that.
Oh, yeah, he just yeah. Mauls him. But 60. Penalty is past the first down marker, so it will be a first down. But great call by Zach Hill. They're anticipating pressure. You countering me here on that?
Well, I just don't want to cut you off, but Brian Harson made contact with the official.
Is that what they called
to? The right conduct. And the Boise State head coach.
I didn't see that.
You can't do that. And it's going to be third down, and they're going a long way back. So they did not give the first down on that play. And on top of that, a 15-yard unsportsmanlike penalty. This right as we were going into that replay. You just can't do this.
No, you cannot. Oh, boy.
There wasn't a lot of contact, but.
Well, I'll tell you what. He's lucky he didn't get booed. Any contact is frowned upon. That's just, you know.
And maybe, I thought it was contact. He got right in his face, and I saw the flag come. Maybe he never actually touched him, but.
Well, he's an intense, emotional guy. I'm going to tell you he's a little bit frustrated with the way this game's going right now. He let his emotions get the best of him, and he hurt his football team here. But that's not something that's typical of Brian Harson.
Yeah, and I didn't mean to cut you off because there was a dispute about the play, and the 74-yard touchdown gets negated. I mean, that was huge. Bachmeyer buying time. He's going to run, and he's not going to get the first down, and he doesn't go down.
There you go down there, and that's another young quarterback just not quite getting it. But it's also a great example of his competitiveness.
So how about this? Marshall gets a huge break. I think it was a legit penalty.
It was absolutely legit. It's a penalty that you have to call.
Yeah.
If you let a coach get out of hand early, it's just not a good scene.
That 15-yard penalty after the play, that really impacted things. So Boise State has to punt the ball. We're under seven to go now in the first half. We got a little bit of a story developing here tonight. For a team that's in the top 25 coming off a huge win, a short punt there. And I get it, the fans here are cranky. And part of it was this, the call, a hold. I mean, that's a hold. It is, but the head coach did not like it. Maybe he thought it didn't impact the play. Now that negated a 74-yard touchdown. This made it worse. Marshall's got the ball back.
ESPN College Football, brought to you by the Lexus ES, a product of mastery. Experience amazing at your Lexus dealer.
Well, why are we showing indoor batting practice? Because Boise State is bringing back the baseball program. I think that's pretty cool. On first down, Marshall with an incompletion. 7-0, the Thundering Herd. Boise fans not thinking about baseball right now. They're thinking about their 24th ranked Broncos team that has a fight on its hands tonight. Marshall has come ready to play. 6:35 to go in the first half, and Boise State, the team that ran up and down the field against Florida State last week, has not scored a point.
Oh, they're struggling, and give great credit to the Marshall defense and the way they're playing, because their offense isn't doing a lot besides the one drive.
Second down, Gaines is in the backfield. Now, he's not lined up as the quarterback, but they're going to pitch it back to the receiver, Johnson, coming to the left side with blockers. Johnson with speed down the sideline. Now, here comes a penalty flag. And just like the long Boise State play that was a touchdown, this one's coming back. We'll see how far. Well, that's going to be the first penalty of the game against the Thundering Herd. Would have been a 38-yard gain instead.
Holding, offense, number 10. 10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul. Second down.
So it'll be second down. Taven Richardson, a wide receiver, called for the hold. That's a big penalty there. We have had so few penalties in the first half, but the penalties have been impactful.
Big ones. I love that play. Use Gaines on the misdirection, run the reverse back the other way. Creative.
They're hard to predict, this Marshall offense.
And they're hard to defend. They've got speed all over the place. And when you take a guy like Gaines and move him all over the field like they're doing, it can create real problems for your defense.
So you still get some positive yardage close to midfield at second and two. Marshall will keep it with Green, the quarterback, first down into Boise State territory.
I'm just surprised at how effective Marshall's running the football against what I think is a really good front seven, front eight, if you count the nickel coming in there, Boise State defense. And they're not doing it with a lot of misdirection. I mean, they're running at them. Good backs, good running quarterback, receivers that'll block.
We've hardly said Curtis Weaver's name.
Well, they're keeping him out of the mix. They know where he is, and they're running away from him. They're not, Boise State's not using him as a rusher much. Got to get him involved.
Knocks the tailback. They fake it to him. Green's got all kinds of time, and he's going deep. And with a lot of contact there, no penalty flag. Gaines can't believe it.
Nice deep ball. You see Walker come in there. That's just a little hand fight.
Yeah.
And then their feet get tangled. I think that's a good no call right there. But once again, you got Gaines, a tight end. Okay, listen, as a tight end, you know, 60 yards, 50 yards down the field on a deep ball, and you have the confidence to throw it to him. What's that say about that kid? He's special.
They were not joking when they said they were going to use him in a lot of different ways.
Oh, you're right about that.
Play clock is winding down. I don't know, Marshall may need to call a timeout. They will get the play snapped. Hand it off. Knox straight ahead running. Stopped at the 46. It'll be third down. As the clock winds, we get down to close to 5 minutes to go in the first half. What a story here so far with this Marshall Thundering Herd team.
If they can continue this drive and get some points, I'll tell you what now, Boise State's going to, they're going to have to figure out some answers.
Some nervous people here watching their Broncos play on the blue turf for the first time. An adjustment to the play call.
Yep. Little game of cat and mouse here. Marshall saw the pressure Boise was bringing from the bottom of the screen. They audible, and now Boise audibles.
I thought they moved, and they did. That might have been a spot where you use one of those three timeouts. They didn't do it. They get penalized.
Offense, number 55. 5-yard penalty. Remains third down.
Maybe the noise for the first time all night was a factor there.
The noise is a factor, and then when you get into an audible system and an offensive lineman has to sit in his stance and sit in his stance and sit in his stance, and he's itching, and he's got a guy, you know, right over his face just snorting at him, you're going to get a jump occasionally.
I think that's a good point. So it's third and 12. Uh-oh. Was all fouled up from the beginning. So Marshall may be being affected by the atmosphere for the first time in this game. Doc is not pleased.
Offense, number 62. 5-yard penalty remains third down. Please reset the game clock to 4:42.
They penalized Kane Matt. I don't think he was the only one.
It's interesting when your guards get false starts. You know, you think the guy that's lined up trying to block Weaver would be the guy trying to get a little head start on the play.
You're right next to the ball.
Yeah. I think the crowd noise is a factor right now. And it's increasing every time they false start.
From third and seven, they were across midfield, now back in their own territory on third and 17. They'll just hand the ball off. Knox picking his way forward, and Knox got pretty close. He at least got to, I doubt they're going to go for it, but he got to a spot where Doc Holliday might have to think about it for a minute.
I think right now you punt him, you pin him down there, your defense is playing great, you can use your timeouts, maybe get the ball back. But what a big play the penalty on the reverse turned out to be right here. Just, obviously it's going to take points off the board.
So a low penalty game, but two big ones big in one. The last sequence, one on each side. Fever's done a good job so far as the Marshall punter. Avery Williams is standing inside the Boise State 10. A high kick, not quite as deep, but still pretty good. Boise State's going to have to start at their own 12-yard line on the blue turf. We'll step aside. The Broncos offense needs to get it going. Friday primetime for Boise, Idaho. Well, now everybody can focus on Friday night college football because we got a game. Boise State for the third time in this first half having to start from inside their own 15-yard line. George Volani with the carry on first down. Marshall with a 7-0 lead here. Boise State getting the ball back.
Gentlemen, we haven't seen Robert Mahone, the leading rusher a week ago against Florida State, over 100 yards. Came off a series ago with a right shoulder. Trainers were working on that shoulder. He has not returned. If something changes, I'll let you know.
They do have another good back, Helani. Play fake to him. Bachmeier down the middle, and a catch by the tight end. John Bates outside the 40. That's a big play. First down, Boise State.
When you're a young quarterback and you're struggling, your best friend is your tight end down the middle of the field, especially a guy like Bates can stretch and make the play because it's an easier throw than throwing the ball outside. That'll give him some comfort.
Gain of 27 yards. He had three big catches, Bates did, against Florida State last week. Left side, Helani squirts through. Well, that was a nice run by the true freshman. The fifth first down for Boise State in this first half.
That's stunning.
They had 38 last week against Florida State.
That's stunning. You know, those first down runs that are successful, that are 4+ yards, are going to help them tremendously because then it opens up the playbook for Zach Hill. And you've got, you know, I know Mahone is out, but Helani is a really good young back.
Not playing too fast. You got plenty of time. One timeout for the Broncos, and that pass tipped up. Helani caught it. I don't know if he thought maybe it was a backwards pass, because that cost Boise State a bunch of yardage. If it goes incomplete, you're back up near midfield. Instead, they go backwards.
I think it's a forward pass, but I believe, you know, your coach is going to tell you every time, try to catch the football.
Yeah.
And it is obviously it's a forward pass, but better safe than sorry.
Yeah. So that turns into a bad break for the Broncos. They go backwards instead of third and short. It's third and 11. Under 2 minutes to go, first half. Marshall showed some pressure, really didn't bring a whole lot of extra pressure. but nobody was open. Bachmeier spins forward, and it's going to depend on the spot. I think he got there. What?
That's a heck of a play by Hank Bachmeier. They were actually spying it. They rushed three, and they took number six, Marquise Couch, and he was spying Hank, and Hank outran the spot. That's a good play.
His head hit the turf, by the way, at the end of that play. I think the spot was a good one. He seems to be just fine.
Well, his head hit the turf a lot last week, and that's not something you want to see.
No.
Not this day and age.
So across midfield, first down. And a little pitch play coming left side with speed to the corner. That's Shakir inside the 30. Shakir picking his way inside the 10, all the way inside the 5. This kid can play. The sophomore from the same hometown as Hank Bachmeier with a big play.
Attacking the edge. They get the edge finally. They seal the inside. And then watch Van Buren out front here. Watch Van Buren with the blocks downfield. That's kind of a little... change in responsibilities. Usually it's a receiver down there mowing someone down. Now you got the back blocking for a receiver. I love it.
You're right. Number 21, Andrew Van Buren.
And Hightower down there getting a block.
That turned that from
a nice play
into a very big play. Now Boise State in no hurry. There is a Marshall player down, so the play and the clock stopped for a moment. That's Jalen McLean Sapp, defensive back. We've seen him make some plays in this first half.
You know, as poorly in a loose way as it's gone for Boise State in this first half offensively, they can go in 7-7. Then you know it's a mulligan. Okay, let's start over now. Let's regroup. All right, let's get it going. Let's settle down.
Remember, no Robert Mahone, as Cart just told us, but George Helani, very talented running back, and Van Buren, and it looks like Van Buren. Is going to get hit right at the line of scrimmage. Still fighting, and the ball came out. The ball is loose. An offensive lineman, I think that's John Molchan, had the ball come right to him. And then he tried to surge it in. Man, Andrew Van Buren, who fumbled against Florida State almost with a huge mistake, and he's going to be coming off the field. You cannot do that.
Try to take the ball away from Molchan.
Yeah.
You're not going to wrestle with him.
This ball definitely comes out.
Big air.
Wow. And Molcha, you're right. The strongest player on the Boise State team made a very big play. Marshall thought they had it, and number 77 said no.
No. And I have it, and you're not getting it back.
Wow. That is a big break for the Broncos. Let's quickly check in studio with Matt.
Time
do
travel.
You have an answer? Oh,
time travel.
Go.
I can guarantee it's not a private jet.
Coach is in really good shape. He's going to get there as fast as he can. And he will be there. You will be there.
I will be there. I can't wait to get there.
It's called an alarm clock.
Get to hang out with Emmanuel Acho all day. Talk about a good day. Watch ball all day. Wall-to-wall ball.
Great,
nothing better.
Great lineup of college football set for tomorrow, especially that Clemson, Texas A&M, and then LSU, Texas game from 3:30 Eastern on into the night. This one, I think, better, more competitive, a lot more competitive than most folks thought. Boise State, it is worth pointing out here, they called the timeout there after that play. So they don't have a timeout left. Just keep that in mind. Second and goal, 43 seconds. Should be plenty of time. But I guarantee you, Andrew Van Buren is not going to be on the field here.
Two fumbles in 2 weeks.
That's not good.
No, and not very good in protection early in this game either.
So Helani is in the backfield, the true freshman, along with the true freshman quarterback. They will give it to George Helani. He takes a big hit. He's still fighting, and he didn't get there.
Yeah, they've got to line up quickly.
Now, Boise State cannot get a personal foul penalty. Lots of pushing and shoving. You're right. The clock is rolling. 30 seconds to go, because you got to think about fourth down if you don't get it.
Yeah, don't fight. Sit on the ground and fight. Get up and line up, and let's run another play.
No timeouts for the Broncos. Well, it's third and goal.
They've got to throw it here, don't they?
I think they do. Bachmeier is going to keep it. Bachmeier dives for the touchdown.
Why throw it when you give it to Hank?
I tell you what, the true freshman, he does have some guts.
Yes, he does.
If you don't get there, I don't think you get points.
You go into half with zero.
Brian Harsin, I'm sure he's happy to have the touchdown, but that was not the most beautiful sequence. That's a terrific effort.
That is. Look, he's struggling throwing the football, but once again, man, when his team needed it, he comes up with a play, and it's a gritty, tough play. I like this kid.
So the extra point coming for Eric Sachs. That one is up and good. 10 seconds on the clock in the first half. The first home touchdown of the year for the Broncos of Boise State. And at least for the moment, all the students who've been waiting all week after last week's win have something to cheer about. 7-7 the score. Let's go down to Kark on the field.
You know, I've been in Boise a few times calling college football. There felt like there was something different in the air. And Dave, we talked about it on our way over here, right? The anticipation of a freshman start. You think about guys like Brett Rippon, who played for 4 years, and Kellen Moore. Well, they got their next guy, and he's one of the guys on the team. You look at the beating he took last week, getting knocked down 28 times. The offensive line took him out for dinner this week. They took care of the young guy, and you could just tell teammates want to play for this kid. I think we're witnessing the first game in Boise of a star.
Well, I think so too. That, you know, that offensive line, they felt guilty, man. It wasn't all on them.
No.
But they were not happy that their true freshman quarterback got licked as many times as he did last week.
The only concern I had about them taking him out to dinner was they took him to sushi. And O-linemen should be eating meat.
Oh, you're in Idaho, home of the ranchers. A little squib kick. And Marshall will do well just to go down. They will have a few seconds, 3 seconds officially on the clock. So unlikely to make anything happen here. That worked out well. It was not perfect for the Broncos, but they get their first touchdown and take the clock almost all the way down to the end.
That was a huge play. I mean, it's a huge touchdown. Getting to even, going in at half. I mean, it's going to make all the difference in the world to their psyche, to their confidence. Their coaches now can go in, get on them a little bit about the things that aren't going well, but great emphasis on the things that they did do well, and that was finished with a touchdown.
And that man is not thrilled.
Well, I don't think he's thrilled with the way his team has played, but I think he's probably a little embarrassed that he hurt his team with the penalty. No coach likes to hurt their team. That's not your job.
So Brian Harsin and the Broncos will try to regroup. They did get the touchdown, though. Marshall has come to play. I mean, this would be a heck of a win for Marshall. Bachmeyer and company trying to avoid that upset and back up their victory against the Seminoles of Florida State. So both teams will head to the locker rooms. Remember, Boise State gets the ball to start the second half. Let's go down on the field with the head coach of the Thundering Herd.
Coach, on the road against a top 25 team, what gave you the belief that your team would be ready to play tonight?
Well, I knew they'd be ready to play. I got a great bunch of kids that love to play the games. I knew we'd be ready to play. It's the kind of game I thought it would be. It's a physical, tough game, and at the end of the day, whoever takes care of the ball can play great defense to win the game.
When we spoke yesterday, you were impressed with this Boise offense. They scored 36 points down in Tallahassee. How have you held them to 7?
Well, kids are just doing what supposed to do. They're playing extremely hard. You know, there's a couple plays there we left out there we should have made, but you got to go to halftime, make a couple adjustments, keep coming out and playing hard.
Thank you, Coach.
Thanks, Tom.
Doc Holliday, good coach. He's got a good team, but the Broncos have Bachmeyer, and he punches it in to tie the game at 7. Time for the Wells Fargo halftime report. No time travel needed. Matt, Joey, and Jesse ready. We had a really interesting first half here in Boise, Idaho, and only that late touchdown from the Broncos tied the game up. Marshall has come ready to play tonight against the 24th ranked team in the country. Hank Bachmeyer and his offense getting ready to come on the field to start the second half. The kickoff into the end zone with a running start. We're going to get a return. Hightower, who's feeling pretty confident as a return man. across the 25. So a few extra yards for Boise State and a push at the end of the play. Dave Fleming, Jim Mora back here in Boise. All right, the numbers were modest, the touchdown at the end, but I think you were still pretty impressed by the kid.
Hank Bachmeyer does things that you don't typically see a true freshman do. I love his footwork in the pocket. I love the fact that he keeps his eyes up here. You see him just moving his feet, finding a different launch point here. The shuffle, keeping his eyes up, finding his outlet receiver, and then the touch throw on the slot fade, and then the toughness to run the ball here on a key third down, going and putting his head down and getting the first down, and then, of course, the touchdown to tie it up before the half. Not a typical true freshman performance so far.
Yeah, that touchdown run was kind of like a do-or-die play. They did not have a timeout, and so he comes out slinging it on the first play of the second half. On target across midfield to his second tight end, Garrett Collingham.
A quarterback's accuracy is tied to his footwork. And when you watch Hank here slide in the pocket, then reset, keep his eyes up the field, and deliver it on time, on target, that's fundamentals. And he is very fundamentally sound. That was a great example of it right there.
24-yard gain. And Boise State may be going to pick up the tempo a little bit. It's something they did against Florida State. And they did so very effectively. That pass dropped by Halani. In the flat, incomplete. Let's go down to Paul Carcaterra.
Dave, moments ago, I caught up with Brian Horace, and I asked him about the unsportsmanlike conduct penalty against him in the second quarter. He said he was emotional. He ran up to the ref. He did make contact. It was not his intent. You guys know Brian Horace, the guy is a complete class act and owned it completely. The other thing, offensively, he feels like if they could protect this freshman quarterback, there are opportunities for deep shots down the field.
Alani gets the carry. There just hasn't been a lot of running room in the traditional run game for the Broncos. It is a good point that Cart makes, and really that the coach was making about the protection. Bachmeyer was under duress most of that first half.
He was, and you saw what he's given some time, like he was on the first down throw, how effective he can be. But they need to be able to run the football. And so far, between Mahone and Alani, now, and Mahone's out, they've got 11 carries for 24 yards. That's not very good. You've got to be able to run the football, at least on early downs, to open it up for your quarterback.
The quarterback run has been the most effective part of Boise's run game. On third and nine, across midfield, first drive of the second half. Broncos trying to get this offense going. In the pocket, and a strike thrown right on target. Hightower to the end zone. Touchdown. What did Harson just say? Give the kid time. There are opportunities to make plays. Yep.
Marshall rushed three. They spied again with Couch. They're going to have to bring pressure. They're going to have to move Hank Bachmeyer off his spot. They're going to have to make a move in the pocket. They're going to have to pressure. He's going to rip them apart. That was a great throw.
How about that start to the second half for a Boise State offense that was very quiet in the first half? It took him a minute and a half to go down the field and get in the end zone. Sacks with the extra point. Hank Bachmeyer. Man, can this kid throw the ball or what?
He can sling it.
And John Hightower showing the speed out in the open field all the way to the end zone. So maybe now the Broncos have got it going. They lead by a touchdown. All right, this season, for every field goal and extra point made by participating universities, Allstate will make a contribution to the university's general scholarship fund. Thank you, Allstate. Back-to-back drives that ended with an extra point for the Broncos. They've taken their first lead on the blue turf in 2019, and it'll be a touchback on the ensuing kickoff.
Marshall's down a man defensively today. Jaquan Yulee suffered a broken neck after colliding with a VMI wide receiver last week. He remained on the field with some movement, and a stretcher was called for immediately. But the good news, guys, a few days ago he posted this on Instagram, himself walking in the hospital, and he later met his teammates on the practice field down in Marshall, and that's a story that makes you smile.
It does. Thank you, Clark. You know, it's sort of a sidebar that he's one of their best players. We're just happy that he's okay. One of his teammates is wearing his jersey. That's Darius Hodge, defensive end. That's not Jaquan out on the field, but A nice tribute, a little swing pass on first down for Marshall, and a great open field tackle. They got the ball in the hands of their playmaker, Xavier Gaines. But Tyreek Jones, who is starting in place of DeAndre Pierce, the would-be starter who's banged up, made a heck of a play.
I like Tyreek Jones. He's long, he's athletic, he's physical. That's a good open field tackle and a really good player, Gaines. How many ways can they get Gaines the ball? I mean, they're very creative with him.
They are trying to answer that question with as many ways as possible. Marshall now behind for the first time on second and long. A shoulder fake. Isaiah Green on the move will take a loss. Well, you should have just thrown that ball away.
Yeah, throw the ball away and save yourself 3 or 4 yards there. I don't understand that play. 7 yards.
Yeah, I mean, you've talked a lot about how he's grown up, matured, he has a command of the offense. That was a mistake, though.
That was a mistake. Look, he's still maturing. You know, he's not there yet. He's still learning. He'll figure it out.
And Doc Holliday knows this game's starting to turn against his Marshall team. And it's also loud. Weaver, the pass rusher, was coming. They get the quick slant out. And one broken tackle, but not another. So that gained just a few yards. Marshall's going to have to punt.
Great job by Curtis Weaver in pursuit. We talked about how hard he plays, what a great player he is. We haven't said his name a lot tonight, but this is a big play because if this guy gets the edge, there's potential for a first down. It just gets him by the shoestring. Watch Weaver dropping here. I'm sorry, coming out of the stack. And look, you know what? That's not Weaver. I'll tell you what now.
I think that's Louie.
That's Louie. Big man running like that. Now, that's even more impressive.
And Weaver was in pursuit. Weaver was on the move, but Louie made a good play. The lower line drive punt. This is the first one that's been returnable for Avery Williams, who's dancing around and now going backwards. So good coverage from Marshall, but it is going to be good field position for Boise State. Marshall's thinking that the ball came out. And I think the officials are saying that forward progress and the play was blown dead. Marshall did come away with the ball, but Boise State's going to have it when we come back, and Bachmeier has led 2 straight touchdown drives. We'll try to make it a third.
Years ago, Paul Reyna was a sought-after recruit from California who found a football home in Boise, Idaho. It was the family atmosphere and the beauty of the area that attracted Reyna to Boise. During an August 18th preseason practice, he fell backwards and struck his head to the turf. He walked off the field but later lost consciousness. The injury created a blood clot that sent Paul into a coma for 5 days. On August 23rd, 1999, he died at the age of 19. His mother, Carolyn Gussman, was in attendance today to take part in the coin toss. And the last thing every Boise State player sees before they take the field is the plaque with Reyna's picture and his mother's quote, "Be not afraid, go out and win championships."
Well, it's a great story, and Paul continues to be a big part of this Boise State program. And that was 20 years ago. Time has passed here in Boise. They have not forgotten Paul Reyna, and that's a good thing. I was really happy that his mom was willing to come back. She talked to the team yesterday. And it's a nice thing that the Broncos do to keep his memory alive.
It's important that the program honors its history, the great players, and then those that made the ultimate sacrifice.
Brian was a teammate, not for long. I mean, Paul had just gotten to campus, essentially, when that terrible accident happened. That pass completed, but it goes backwards. So it's going to be second down for Boise State after a good run on first down. Anyway, Brian has made sure, a kid who grew up here in Boise, went to Capital High School, played for the Broncos, now the head coach of the Broncos. Nobody appreciates the history of this place more than he does. And he had some very poignant words about his one-time teammate yesterday when we asked him about him. Anyway, I'm glad the Broncos did that. The Boise State with the ball back, leading by a touchdown. through freshman quarterback Hank Bachmeyer, who's starting to spin it, and he's starting to find some receivers that are open. John Bates with the catch and run, the tight end, for another Boise first down.
Marshall decided to bring pressure here. They got a little confused in their rush zones, left a little throwing lane for Hank, and then the crossing route beats the underneath coverage for the first down. It's always risky when you decide to pressure. If you don't hit it just right, there's throwing lanes and there's guys open.
Those tight ends, they're going to be a big part of the passing game for Boise State this year. They already have been. George Helani, another true freshman, alone in the backfield. He takes the handoff. He does have a good burst, Helani. He only got a couple yards on that run. He's talented.
Yeah, he's very patient when he gets the ball. He understands where the block's going. He understands where the hole is going to be. And then he dances a little, and he's able to hit it downhill. You saw that against Florida State. You saw it on the first play of this drive, a really nice run. Your comment about the tight ends, and I said it earlier, a great receiving tight end is the best friend of a young quarterback. You know, he's a safety valve over in the middle that he can go to when things are breaking down, and they've got some really good tight ends here at Boise State.
And Bates and Collingham both have made big plays in this one. From the shotgun, the handoff, big hole, Helani. There's the true freshman runner inside the 20. Now this Boise State offense, it took them a while against a good Marshall defense, but they have figured some things out.
Yep, a little misdirection there. Get the defensive line going one way, the linebackers going the other way, they run a counter play. Nice cut by Helani, nice vision by Helani, nice downfield blocked by the receivers again. Get this run game going, and it's going to open everything up for this offense.
You think Broncos fans are sitting back going, huh, our quarterback is a true freshman. Our super talented tailback is a true freshman. We're going to see those guys standing right next to each other a lot over the next few years. And then with all those glowing words, a bad snap and a big loss on first down. That one hurts.
To your point, though, the future is bright at the skill positions here. The challenge is always going to be replacing those big guys up front because they are an experienced offensive line. And I'm sure that they give Coach Harsin, and I know they give Hank, a sense of comfort. Stand behind those guys, especially when they take you out to sushi, right?
They're trying to take care of their young QB. That was a 10-yard loss on that snap from Garrett Larson. He's a good center. A rare mistake from him. Bachmeyer dancing around and gets hit from behind. He goes down. I think that's Marquise Couch who comes up with the sack.
Hank's done a nice job tonight of extending plays with his feet, staying alive in the pocket, and here he just drifts into the rush. And that's really just an effort rush there by Couch. Give him credit. I don't think there's any way to blame Hank. Nope. Didn't get rid of the ball or anything like that. It was just a good play by the defense.
That's the ninth time he's been hit in this game. He got hit 28 times in week one at Florida State. They were inside the 20 first and 10. Now they're back at the 35 on third down. Bachmeyer again, pressured, steps up, and throws incomplete. So fourth down coming up. You're not really in field goal range. This drive, which was so promising, has gone in the wrong direction. We'll see what Brian Harsin wants to do. I say they're not in field goal range, but I guess conceivably they are. On fourth down, it looks to me like they're keeping the offense on the field.
This is a tough call. It is fourth and four, fourth and six, seven, something like that. I can see it, but you're sitting here at fourth and forever. You don't have a lot of fourth and 27 calls in your playbook. They've obviously got one, though.
Maybe a pooch punt. Is that possible? Does
he'd be lined up deeper.
Yeah. He steps up. Why not just heave it to the end zone? It is incomplete. I'm not sure he made that one catchable for Butler. So they were inside the 20, first and 10, and on the move and looking to put some distance between themselves and the thundering herd. And the Marshall defense, with some help, came up with a big stop. So Marshall gets the ball back here in Boise, Idaho, when we come back.
ESPN College Football, brought to you by Nutro Wholesome Essentials Pet Foods. Nutro, feed the clean.
They love the great outdoors here in Boise, Idaho. They love their blue turf. They love their Broncos. And Marshall, whose offense started off this game hot.
False start. Offense, number 71. 5-yard penalty remains first down.
That has been a problem. Is that the third false start from their offensive line?
Yep, and that's not how you want to start a drive after your defense has made a big fourth down stop, and you need to get yourself back in the game. Those unforced errors, they will absolutely kill a team.
Now, last drive, they ended up going well backwards. They start off this drive with a 5-yard loss. That's a good run. That could have been a loss for Brendan Knox. He got back to the original line of scrimmage to set up second and 10.
That was outside zone, a stretch play. He just puts his left foot in the ground and plants it and gets upfield for 5, 4.5.
Yeah, I gave him a little extra on the run. It was still a positive play. It's second and 11. So far, the total yardage, now this is only their second drive of the third quarter, but they're still in the negative. They have yet to get a first down since halftime.
I expected a faster tempo by both teams offensively.
Green, the quarterback, throws down the sideline, incomplete. Well, Willie Johnson had a chance there, I think, to get his hands on the ball.
Good coverage downfield. Bump and run into the boundary, gets his hands on him. Got a little step on him, though. That's a tough catch, but you got to help your quarterback. You got to find a way to bring that down.
Yeah, he had a chance to make a play there.
Yep. Sometimes it's tough to track the ball at night. A little bit different than playing in the daylight.
So now it's third and 11. And it's going to get louder as they try to make an adjustment to this play call. Play clock down to 2, down to 1. They get the ball snapped. Pressure immediately in the sack. And that's Curtis Weaver.
Now we're calling his name. This is a really good football player. We haven't heard a lot from tonight. Here they put him at left defensive end, attacking the right tackle. Really good pass rush move. Quick off the ball, uses his hands well. Excellent finish. Guy plays with tremendous effort. He's technically sound. He loves to play football, and they use him all over the field. It's good to see him make a play.
Career sack number 22 for Curtis Weaver, who was the preseason defensive player of the year in the Mountain West Conference. A punt and a fair catch signal right around the 32-yard line where the Broncos will get the ball back. Well, tomorrow, Saturday, can't miss college football doubleheader on ABC and the ESPN app. Number one, Clemson's going to host Texas A&M. A&M looked really good week one. They challenged Clemson last year. That's going to be a good game. And then they have been waiting for this kind of game for a long time in Austin. The Longhorns and the LSU Tigers, 7:30 Eastern. Joe Burrow, Sam Ellinger, he may have to do a lot of running. Joe Burrow has brought some passing game to LSU. They've been missing that for a good long while.
I'll tell you what I'm excited to watch. LSU's defense. You talk about how Marshall flies around.
Yeah.
Tune in and watch LSU play defense tomorrow.
It's going to be a theme of your broadcast this
year. I love defense.
Excited for defense. Well, I do too. Bachmeier going down the left sideline. Incomplete. Good coverage there. Really good coverage.
It's the long foul ball right there. You've probably said that a few times, right?
I have. Yeah. Some foul balls are prettier than others. That was a pretty one. You get to watch the ball.
You see his touch at least. I know it's an incompletion, but he can throw with accuracy. He can throw with touch. He can throw distance. I like this kid.
Boise has been trying to take some chances downfield in this second half. On second and 10, Bachmeier's going to throw it again. This time a quick hitter over the middle. And the move to get away from the first would-be tackler gets Boise State the first down. Evans with the catch and run.
You know, that looks like an ordinary throw, but it's not. And here's what's impressive about it there is there was pressure in Bachmeier's face. He found the vacated zone that they vacated with the pressure, and he stuck it right on the guy's chest. You know, and it looks ordinary, not easy to do.
Boise State's moving the ball in the second half. Only one touchdown in their first two drives. Alani gets the carry, and he just ran a defender over. That is some tough guy running for a true freshman who's listed at 192 pounds.
Nothing gets your offense going better than running the football. And then when a true freshman, like you just said, runs over a DB, I mean, everybody gets fired up. The offensive line gets fired up. The sideline gets fired up. The fans get fired up. You know, that juice, that energy that Boise State didn't have, and now he's walking off the field.
Yeah.
That juice that they were missing in the first half, they're kind of capturing that now.
Nazee Johnson, hopefully he's okay. He took the wrong end of that collision.
And you know what? That's a really good football player right there. He had a hit last week against VMI where he filled the lane and reminded me of Ronnie Lott hitting Icky Woods in the Super Bowl. So it's a good player right there. And so that says a lot to me about George Helani out of St. John Bosco. They put some players into the college football ranks.
Yes, they have.
I got to coach one, Josh Rosen.
A powerhouse program these days in Southern California. George Helani, just like Hank Bachmeier, Southern California kids coming here to Boise. And a very bright future ahead. That time, though, Marshall got into the backfield and stuffed Helani for a loss. It's third down.
Nice job by the inside linebacker, Omari Cobb, filling, taking on the offensive line block, keeping his outside arm free and making the play in his gap. That's just downhill football. Yeah. And that's what they've got to do when you're at a size disadvantage. You've got to attack your gaps.
And Cobb's a guy who's moved to the middle. We saw the story of Jaquan Ulee, who hurt his neck last week. He's going to be okay, but he's obviously out this week. Third down and short. Pressure coming. Bachmeier delivers, takes a hit, and right there for a first down. Man, and he pops back up again. This kid is something else.
This is classic Hank Bachmeier. This is Brett Favre-like. This is Drew Brees, Tom Brady, unfazed by the pressure, not throwing off his back foot, no hesitation, just step right up, know he's going to get hit, and deliver a strike. That's big time football for anyone, let alone a true freshman.
It's his second game. Boise State has found a quarterback for now and for a good long while. Under 3 minutes to go, third quarter. They will hand the ball off, and a nice hole. Bounce to the outside. That's Andrew Van Buren, who gets close, maybe not quite to first down yardage, but a good run.
And that's got to feel good for Van Buren. You know, he hadn't taken a snap since he fumbled down there at the end of the first half. So get him back in. You're running the ball. Get him some confidence. You know, we don't know where Mahone is in terms of his injury, so they're going to need Van Buren. So I like the way that they're getting him in there, get him the ball.
I mean, he's talented. Yep. It has to take a little something from a head coach, doesn't it? That's 2 weeks in a row he has fumbled. Mm-hmm. To get him back in there and give him another chance. We haven't seen Robert Mahone in a while. Van Buren on the left side, inside the 20, down to the 16.
One thing you're going to see, you're going to see Van Buren taking care of the football. Watch him cover it up with both hands on contact. I mean, he's going to make sure he holds onto that ball. You might get a second chance. When you start fumbling as a running back, you don't necessarily get that third chance. Good ball security here, though.
This was right about where they got last drive, and then they started going backwards. See if they can do it a little better this time. Boise State ahead by a touchdown on the move again. Bachmeier under center. Van Buren spun away from one tackle and got a yard, and he was holding on to that football. Yeah, by the way, Robert Mahone, who had the big game, a career game last week, he's still got the pads on. Mm-hmm. He's not in the locker room. And Paul reported some sort of shoulder issue. Seven rushes, 14 yards. Much quieter night so far here tonight, but at least he's still on the sideline.
Yeah, that's good to see. He's suited up and probably just trying to take care of him a little bit.
They definitely believe he's going to be a big part of their backfield this year. Second and nine. Bachmeier with a play fake. And that one tipped up and intercepted. That's Omari Cobb, who comes away with a turnover. So the second straight time Boise State gets inside the 20 and they don't score any points. That tip ball turns into an interception. Heck of a play by Omari Cobb. Still reason for those folks to be a little concerned tonight.
Yeah, play action here, and Cobb really doesn't bite on it, and he's able to get back into coverage, get a tip ball. Hey, tips and overthrows, those got to belong to the defense. You see the tip ball right there by Cobb to Cobb. That's an athletic move, and they talk about his athleticism and playing him in there. That's a darn good play.
And Marshall needed that badly.
Yes, they did.
The senior from Point St. Lucie, they're more Florida kids on this Marshall team than from any other place. Under a minute to go, third quarter. Green will sling it out on the left sideline and just nowhere for the receiver Gaines to go.
so impressed with Curtis Weaver. I mean, everyone talks about his pass rushing ability with over 20 sacks in his first 2 years. How about against the run and his overall durability? Against Florida State, he was the only defensive player to play every single snap, and he has not come off the field tonight either.
You don't want to take that guy off the field. You want him on the field, and he played so hard at Florida State. Signature of this defense all the way around, but he really epitomizes it.
Handed off to Johnson coming around the left side, and he gets shoved out of bounds. Maybe went backwards there. On what will probably be the final play of the third quarter, the clock moves.
Nice job again by Weaver there, making the runner redirect.
Well, we know he's not coming off the field for third and 11. When we come back here to Boise, Hank Bachmeier on the Broncos offense. Not been perfect tonight, but enough to take a touchdown lead to quarter number four. Well, Marshall has a tremendous history of quarterback play. Chad Pennington, who hooked up with Randy Moss so many times in his career. Byron Leftwich, who was one of the best players in college football in his Marshall career, went on to a long NFL career. Now a coach, Isaiah Green, maybe not quite in that tier of talent, at least not yet, but the sophomore, they're going to need something from him in this fourth quarter. Third and 11, first play of the quarter, and Green gets knocked down. The ball is out. And Marshall fell on the ball. I think Green saying it was an incomplete pass. Kakala Kaniho is the guy who got in there and knocked it away. And if it is a fumble, it's a negative yardage play. What do you think?
I think it's an incomplete pass. But I love the pressure off the edge by Kaniho. It's reminiscent of last week against Florida State when he came through the B gap and made the big play. They use him in a variety of ways, but the best thing he does is rush the passer.
Since halftime, Marshall has gone backwards on all three drives. They have negative yardage for the half. And now they're going to have to punt from the goal line, essentially. And the play clock is expired. Nobody seems to know it yet. It took the officials even a couple seconds to figure that out.
5 yard penalty, remains fourth down.
So for Marshall and Doc Holliday, their head coach, so crisp at the start of the game, so much energy and pace on both sides, and things are bogged down on offense.
And that play right there is just a lack of concentration and focus. That shouldn't happen to your punt team. Get out there and kick the ball. That's all you're doing.
Instead of on the goal line, well into the end zone. That could be returnable. Big hit right as Avery Williams fielded it, and he got away. Wow, what a broken tackle from Avery Williams, and he gets inside the 30. Now there is a penalty flag down. Terrific effort from Avery Williams. That was an escape.
Look at Avery Williams yesterday at practice. He's got legs like a jackhammer. Mind you, Maurice Jones-Drew.
During the return, personal foul, blindside block by the receiving team, number 3. 15-yard penalty from the spot of the foul. First down, Boise State.
They have tweaked this rule a little bit this year. The blindside block, 15-yard penalty. That is a big penalty against Boise State. And there are those jackhammer legs from Williams to get away somehow.
Great second effort.
There's the penalty. That's close.
It's a close one, but in the name of player safety, I think it's a call you're going to see made. You know, there's such an emphasis on player safety, and rightly so, but we don't want to get too nitpicky.
And they're trying to protect players who cannot possibly see something coming from getting hurt.
They can't defend themselves. Yeah, and I understand that, and I agree with that.
But instead of the ball down inside the 30 of Marshall, Boise's back at its own 41. That's about a 35-yard difference, that penalty. So that's big. Touchdown lead for the number 24 ranked team in the country. Bachmeier on the move. Bachmeier throws short.
He just strung it out as long as he could and found a positive gain.
And tremendous awareness there. You know, eyes down the field. He's looking for Hightower along the sideline. It wasn't there. Shifts his eyes back inside and finds that secondary receiver in the little hole in the zone there. Not always a throw you'd encourage throwing across your body, but it was a safe throw in that case.
Well, he's played a heck of a game. Maybe not as spectacular numbers-wise as last week against Florida State. He's made some really nice plays. On second down, Halani gets the handoff across midfield. Good enough for a first down. So the Broncos move the chains. The 50th season of Monday Night Football kicks off on ESPN, ESPN Deportes, and the ESPN app. Our annual Week 1 doubleheader. That's this Monday, September 9th. First, you get the Saints and the Texans at 7 Eastern, and then out of the Bay Area. Not much going on around that game. The Broncos and the Raiders, 10:15 Eastern or thereabouts. Special edition of Monday Night Countdown at 5 Eastern. This Monday, Monday Night Football celebrates 50 years. First down, Boise State, George Halani for a gain of a couple. Marshall's defense still playing hard, still playing well.
I think they're playing hard. I think you'll never see them not play hard. I think they're getting worn down just a little bit. I think the size mismatch is starting to show up. Now, that wasn't a great run, but you're seeing more holes. You're seeing, you know, they're getting pushed back a little bit more.
Boise State really, I mean, maybe a little quick tempo early in the third quarter. Otherwise, we have not seen much of it from them. Bachmeier delivers incomplete. He took another hit. They had two pass rushers come in, and Van Buren picked up one of them, but he couldn't pick up both.
Couldn't get them both, and that's been a theme tonight as they've been attacking the back. Marshall's blitz package is attacking the back through the B gap, and they're trying to get a two-on-one on the back and make him decide who to block. He's got to pick one. He picks the inside guy. The outside guy gets the hit. But Hank was able to get it out.
He did. Avoid that negative play. So instead of maybe third and 15, something like that, it's third and 8. Broncos continue to move the ball. Last two drives have ended in frustration for Boise State. Bachmeier in the pocket, steps up, and the ball's out. He got hit from behind, and Marshall has the football. A strip sack for the Thundering Herd, and that's a turnover.
You're not going to see Ezra Cleveland get beat a lot on the edge, but he got beat there.
I think Fermin Silva may be the guy who knocked it out, and he's the player who's down. Sam Burton, the redshirt freshman, I think recovered it. That's the outstanding left tackle. He did get beat. Wow.
You know what? You never encourage holding, but when you're beat like that, like he is right there, grab him. Don't let him hit your quarterback in the back.
Well, the Thundering Herd are hanging in there. They're down by just a touchdown, and they will have good field position when we come back to Boise. Well, if you can, we do ask that you please help the many, many people affected by Hurricane Dorian. You can donate now at www.redcross.org/ESPN. You can also call 800-RED-CROSS to donate now. A lot of people need a lot of help. Marshall with the football after the turnover and a designed run for their super weapon Xavier Gaines, who took that direct snap again. He's done that several times in this game. They're at midfield. Jim, you know, they've spent so much of this second half way down in their own end without maybe the ability to use their whole playbook. Now they're at midfield. Maybe they can start to do that again. And they're going to go
double
quicker.
Pass.
Yeah. Gaines is going to throw into coverage, incomplete, and lucky that it was just incomplete. Boise State was not fooled. Tyler King, the running back, was out there in the pass pattern.
It's hard to fool the Boise State defensive backs because they are a veteran duo. They are smart. They are disciplined. As a team in general, they play good, disciplined football. It's hard to get those plays on a team like this. They don't get sucked up.
So third and 5, down a touchdown in the fourth quarter. Maybe Marshall would think that this would be a spot where you have two plays to get your 5 yards. We'll see. Isaiah Green in the pocket, pressured, and he's going to go down.
That may take the decision out of Doc Holliday's hands. A sack for the Broncos defense. Dimitri Washington, the redshirt freshman, and I think Curtis Weaver got in there at the end of the play. But Washington's the guy who really created that rush.
Yeah, it's a good move off the right side here by Halata, and then Washington with the inside rush, and then Weaver with the finish off. And I like how Weaver got excited for his teammate getting a sack, because that's the guy who backs him up.
Yep.
That stud.
You're right. Maybe the future stud for the Broncos.
You know what? It kind of captures the culture here at Boise State that has long been in play. They play for each other. They play hard. They play with discipline. They care about each other. It's about the team first. And, you know, Weaver's a guy that really exemplifies that.
Well, that turns into a good punt with the bounce. So the Broncos trying to put away Marshall. That is not going to be easy tonight. Still more than 11 minutes to go and a touchdown lead. Well, John Doc Holliday, one of the great characters and a really good football coach, has been around this game a long time. He shares that name and nickname with one of the most famous characters in the history of the American West. Yeah, we're comparing the Doc Holliday and this Doc Holliday. They were both born back east. They both did their, you might not have known this about the original Doc Holliday. He went to dental school in Pennsylvania. They both eventually made their way out west. The biggest wins, you could say, in each of their careers at the OK Corral.
Yeah.
And then the national championship game in Glendale. Notice the tumbleweed. That was a nice touch. Doc Holliday died at a young age in Glenwood Springs, Colorado, where he is buried. This Doc Holliday, he's hoping to actually make it back home at the end of this game.
Well, he's alive and kicking tonight.
He is. He's a fun guy to talk to, Paul. We enjoyed our time with Doc Holliday.
You know, Doc Holliday's got some ball players. Always been able to recruit Florida. 34 players on his roster from Florida. When he was an assistant coach at West Virginia in 1979, he told us he was one of only three coaches down there recruiting South Florida. Oh, how time has changed.
No kidding. Hand off for Boise State, and Halani with a nice run and a broken tackle for Broncos first down. We really looked hard to find out if the original gambler and gunslinger Doc Holliday made it to Florida, did any recruiting down there for his OK Corral gang. We couldn't find evidence of that.
No, we didn't find any of that. This guy is a really good, he's like an old-time ball coach, isn't he? When you go in and talk to him, you sit down, he's got he's always got his football coaching gear on, and he loves to talk ball.
That's the first time the Fiesta Bowl has ever been compared to the gunfight at the OK Corral, I believe. Alani across the 25 out to the 26. How much fight do the Thundering Herd have left in them? They have played hard all the way through, and they've made a few big plays on defense here in this second half to keep this a one-score game.
Thundering Herd, they aren't going to quit. It's not in their character. They love to play football. They love to compete. Boise State, though, has had three really good plays, digging the ball out from the 10, finding some space. Probably run it again, maybe take a shot here somewhere.
We're under 10 minutes to go now on the blue turf for the first time. Halani took a big pop, gets stopped a yard short, so you got third and short coming up. There's been a big difference in the way these teams have moved the ball in the second half. Boise State approaching 200 yards and approaching 400 for the game. Marshall is in negative yardage territory for the second half, and yet the Broncos only have the 1 second half touchdown. They haven't fully taken advantage of that.
Well, you said it. Their defense has come up with some big plays at key moments to stop Boise State drives.
So now, sort of that jumbo package on third and one. Halani is not going to get there. And another big play and stop. Omari Cobb, Jalen McClain, Sapp and company right in there. So it's not just the big guys on the defensive line in run support.
It's good football. I mean, watch them. They play square to the line of scrimmage. They don't get knocked off the ball. They play with great pad level, and then they tackle. And I said that early in the game. Early in the season, you don't see great tackling in college football. But this Marshall team, they run, and they will sting you.
Isn't it interesting? I mean, I think just about everybody thought the Boise State offensive line, that would be a mismatch in their favor. That has definitely not been the case. They almost got there and blocked that punt, and they may have forced a shorter punt. Though the Marshall offense has not been robust in the second half. They needed to be here. Down by a touchdown, 8+ to go.
A new culture in College Station.
Trevor Lawrence looks like a generational talent.
We're back.
We fight like tigers. Can you feel it?
I personally am not making any declarations about who's back, who's not back, anything like that. I'm just going to watch those games and really enjoy them. We got two super games tomorrow lined up on ABC. And more than that, even as Marshall gets the ball back and some tough running from their power back, Brendan Knox, the Thundering Herd, down by 7.
I know there's 8 minutes left in the game, but they've got to capitalize on this field position. They've got to put points on the board. They've got to give their defense a little bit of a rest. The defense has been on the field a lot the second half, playing very well, but they'll eventually wear down.
And time is going to be a factor here sooner rather than later. Going downfield, and that's a jump ball, and it is intercepted. Intercepted by the Broncos defense. Is that Nawahine?
Yes, it is.
What a great play. Second Marshall turnover, and Doc Holliday is fuming.
One of the things that Marshall wanted to try to do was get the safety, specifically Nawahine, isolated downfield on a receiver. They tried it there. Veteran DB comes up with a big play on a little bit underthrown ball.
Yeah, it's almost like the ball was late, too. And I don't know if he had an opportunity to throw it earlier or what, but I think the receiver was open there for a minute.
He was. And if you throw it away from the defender.
The previous play of the interception by the defense is under review.
Well, they're going to take a look and make sure that it actually was an interception by Kakoa Nawahine, the senior from right outside Boise.
I saw him in practice yesterday working with Jeff Schmetting on coverage stuff down in the end zone during his special teams period.
Huh. I think the work paid off. They're going to look at it, and we'll be back right after this. Well, you can see why the replay crew wanted to take an extra look at this, but Kakoa Nawahine, even though initially was juggling the ball, never hit the blue turf. He secures possession, rolls over, he's inbounds. They confirm the call. Yeah, that guy came up with the interception. How about the second half defense? They shut out Florida State last week, and the total yardage was below 70. The total yardage is 0 for Marshall in the second half this week, as the freshman Halani on first down gets a gain out to the 30-yard line. 7.5 minutes to go. How long can this Marshall defense hold up and give the Thundering Herd at least a chance in this game?
We're going to see. They've got to be able to stop the first down run. If they can't do that, then it's going to be tough.
I mean, it's amazing, a team that put all those points, all those yards, all those first downs on the board last week against Florida State. It has not been easy tonight. That's a good run straight ahead for a Broncos first down.
You're starting to see surge up front out of the Boise State offensive line. And we've been a little concerned about them because they are a veteran group. They are probably the strength of this team. Early in the game, struggling to run the ball, but now you're seeing that surge.
Maybe that difference starts to play a bigger factor as the game goes on, that size difference up front.
Absolutely. You just, you know, you get worn down. You can only hold up so long.
Pitch play, trying to get out to the corner. Does not want to go out of bounds, so Shakir ends up losing a couple yards on first down.
You know, Jim, you're mentioning that surge, but credit Marshall's defense. I mean, they have put forth such an incredible effort tonight. And man, we thought this would be a big advantage. I mean, Boise returns 5 starters on the offensive line. Average guy weighs 306 pounds compared to the defensive line of Marshall at 254. These guys have held up to now, but is it too much in the fourth?
They've stayed hydrated, Marshall has. Incompletion across the middle. to set up third down. Look, I don't like the transitive property of college football because this team beat that team and this team lost to this team. That means this team could beat that team. But there's some folks in Tallahassee tonight watching this game going, huh, this is the team that came in and yep. just rolled us over in the second half. And Marshall is putting up a heck of a fight on the road a long way from home against this same Broncos team. That clock stoppage definitely helps Marshall. Bachmeier with some pressure picked up. He's got time, and that throw is caught at midfield. What a big completion. A terrific catch by Khalil Shakir. That was good coverage.
This is a great throw. That's a far hash throw. It's a receiver running an out cut from the inside, who's well covered, as you said, and Hank putting it there on time, and a really nice job up front and by the backs and protection as well.
So now at midfield, a first down, and that clock will roll again. Even one more first down if Boise State just keeps the ball on the ground, and Marshall's going to have to start thinking about their timeouts, but another negative run play.
Well, you know, Clark talked about it. I talked about it. They were starting to get that surge up front. As hard as Marshall's played, you know, you start to get worn down eventually. But every time here in this drive that Boise State runs to the edge, runs laterally, it's a negative play. There's two of them right there. So I don't understand, and there's a lot of understand people would tell you, why not just run it at them?
I think it's a fair question.
We'll ask Brian.
We'll be back here in a couple weeks. That's a completion. You're leaning on your true freshman very close, a little bit short. You don't want incompletions that stop the clock. You want him to put the ball on the money, keep that clock going.
That shows the confidence that this staff has in,
I think that's right.
Hank Bachmeier.
He has earned it fast. It was not a done deal that he was going to be the starting quarterback. He had to earn the job. He came here early. Got to Boise in January after finishing high school early. Third and short. These plays have not been simple for the Broncos tonight. They're going to throw the ball. That tells you a lot. And Bachmeier, the helmet gets ripped off. What a mistake that is. He was dead. That was going to be a sack and a huge negative yardage play. And instead, it's going to be a penalty against Marshall and a Boise State first down. Wow. There are three different flags on the field. That was, I don't think it was intentional, but that looked vicious when it happened. Boise State fans are thinking it was pretty vicious.
Face mask, defense number 95. 15-yard penalty from your previous spot. Automatic first down. Number 19 does not have to leave the game for his helmet coming off due to the foul.
They're already, it's two games already saying, do not mess with our guy. Wow.
That's just an effort penalty right there. That's not intentional.
No, but it is a big mistake because he was going down. There was nowhere for him to go.
Interesting call on third and one when you're running the ball well. But they had Collingham wide open. You'll see him in the background downfield. So interesting call. Good call. Penalty works out.
Boise State, the clock moves again inside the 30 of Marshall. They would like to end this game in the end zone, I think, in an ideal world. They may not be able to do that, but I think they would like to.
That's the best way to end a game. Put it in the end zone. Kick the extra point.
You know, another thing that they're doing here, but that play was snapped with 15 seconds on the play clock. If you're Boise State, do you want more time than that off the clock?
Yes, you absolutely do. And, you know, maybe that's the next step for Hank. Right now, maybe that's not their biggest concern. You know, it's teaching them how to run their offense. They've snapped at six there. That's a little bit better.
Alani gets close but stops short. And Marshall is going to call a timeout, which you save the time whenever you use those timeouts.
Marshall, their first, 30 second.
So with 3:02 on the clock, another third down coming. That gives us a chance while they regroup on both sidelines. A reminder, and UFC 242, I took a shot the first time. Habib is going to fight against Dustin. They're on a first-name basis for us. Saturday 2 Eastern, exclusive pay-per-view on ESPN+. Check it out, ESPNplus.com/PPV. I don't need to use just first names once we switch back to college football. Texas A&M, Jimbo and Dabo, I could go first names with everybody. 3:30 Eastern from Death Valley, and then LSU goes on the road to Austin. Number 6 against number 9, primetime, 7:30 Eastern, 4:30 Pacific, also on ABC. That is all coming up tomorrow. Kellen Mond, Trevor Lawrence. Kellen Mond played great in week 1. Trevor Lawrence did not.
But Travis Etienne did.
Yes, he did.
Yes, he did.
Yes, he did.
And T. Higgins did.
There's a lot of talent on that Clemson team.
You aren't kidding.
So 3rd and 2. Maybe the play of the game for Marshall right here with 2 timeouts remaining. They just stopped the clock. And Boise will hand it off. And a tackle with the lunge for the first down. Now the clock is going to move. I don't know. That was the tight end Collingham coming around the end. This one's going to depend on the spot, and I think they spotted him a little bit short.
Right.
Now the clock continues to move. Are they saying first down? Wow. If I were Marshall, I'm saying, well, you got to look at that.
Timeout.
Marshall will call a timeout, but
their second.
The ball also, he's down. The ground forces the fumble. The ball came out. I don't know about that. They didn't even measure. There may be a few things to sort out here. We will sort things out ourselves. Come back with 2:56 on the clock. All right, out of the timeout, Boise State does have a first down. I'm shocked. I mean, I can't believe that somebody didn't ask the officials to take a look at the spot. They just gave the first down. And Doc Holliday knows that his team is in big trouble now. They had to use their second timeout, and it's 1st and 10, Boise State. Not quite victory formation time, but Halani gets tackled after a gain of a yard. I guess Marshall will use their final timeout or no. Only have one, so they just pick their spot when they'll stop the clock.
It doesn't matter if you use it here or the next play. Maybe you use it after 2nd down.
So we've seen a pass on 3rd and a yard. We've seen a sweep to a tight end on 3rd and a yard.
You know, I'm not sure what that says, but does it call into question the confidence of the coaching staff in the ability of the offensive line to move Marshall off the ball, which is a great credit to Marshall.
2nd and 9, Halani bursts through. Halani still going, gets wrestled down inside the 10. That clock continues to move. We're down to 2 minutes to go. Boise State, after their thrilling come-from-behind win in Tallahassee against Florida State, into the top 25, playing on the blue turf here at home for the first time this year. Having to hang on for dear life at home against a very game Marshall team. That run, by the way, puts Halani over 100 yards. That ends Marshall's streak of not allowing a 100-yard rusher in more than a year.
Marshall's going to bring everybody here. They've got to. They got to sell out to stop the run.
On 3rd and 3, and Halani will not get the ball. Bachmeier keeps it. Bachmeier And we'll see where they put the ball down. They stopped the clock momentarily. The football ended up out. Did he get the first down? I guess he did, yeah.
Well, Doc is not happy with the official. He better be careful or he might be drawing a 15.
Their third. Full timeout.
And what an athletic play. Tavante Beckett, he actually got the ball. Now, I'm not saying it was an actual fumble, but the ball came out. He grabbed it and stayed in bounds just in case it had been. Can you imagine that?
Mm.
I mean, assuming this is a first down, the game's going to be over. Boise State's going to take a knee. Well, look at that. That is amazing. Marshall has not had a first down. Boise State's had 15 of them in the second half. They've turned that into all of 7 points. One touchdown. But it's probably not going to matter. The Mountain West is not going to be a cakewalk, just like this game has not been. The Mountain West had a great week one. Wyoming, I know it was at home, but Missouri's
they beat an SEC team.
And a team that's expected to win a lot of games. The 50-plus yard field goal from the freshman walk-on. Nevada beat Purdue. Hawaii, it was an escape, but they beat a Pac-12 team to start their year. And Boise State with the comeback win. That was the signature win for the league, but not the only good win for the Mountain West.
Oh, a bunch of good wins. Four good wins.
Most of any conference against Power 5 schools in week one. SEC and ACC had four also. Well, it was a first down. Marshall doesn't have a timeout. And that means that all Boise State has to do after this is snap it one more time. Well, what do you think?
Well, I'll tell you this about what Boise State and Coach Harsin are doing right now with the kneel down. They're paying respect to Marshall. I like a coach that respects the game and the men that play it enough to not try to rub their faces in it and try to score again, because you'll see a lot of coaches do that. And to me, it's disrespectful to the players and it's disrespectful to the game. And you're not going to see that when you're talking about a Brian Harsin coach team. This is classy.
Now Marshall earned the respect tonight
because they deserve it.
Oh. Really hard. Their
yes,
offense just could not do anything.
Nope.
And maybe the Broncos defense is largely responsible for that. But if Boise State fans thought after the win against Florida State that this season was just going to be an easy cakewalk to an undefeated regular year, tonight is a little bit of a wake-up call.
I think so. And, you know, it to the fans it is, to the coaches, it's not. Yeah, coaches never take a game for game for granted. It's not in the DNA of a coach. But great learning experience, I think, tonight for the Broncos. There are no such thing as moral victories, but a great fight put up by Marshall and Doc Holliday and his staff and his team. A lot to be proud of, but it's still a tough loss.
So Boise State finds a way to get the win here at home, 14-7. Is Kark ready down on the field? I think he is. Let's go down to Paul.
Thank you, Dave. Coach, that was a tough game. Where were you tested the most?
Well, four quarters. You know, we knew Marshall was tough. We talked about it all week. And for us to come out here and get ready to play again, that's always the challenge. What do you do from week one to week two? So I thought across the board, it was a hard-fought game, but there's a lot of things we'll go back and correct. But I'm proud of our team. We won the game, and that's really the ultimate goal. So we'll clean it up. We'll get better at it. We've got to make better decisions out there, all those things. But proud of these guys here at home on the blue. Had a great crowd tonight, so we'll take it.
It was a beautiful night. Your freshman quarterback last week in Tallahassee, Hank Bachmeier, took some hits. Tonight he took some hits. How would you describe his toughness?
Well, he keeps showing it, and not because we want to go out there and test it ourselves. So we've got to find a way to protect him, and he continues to show, you know, what he's capable of doing, of playing and coming back after taking a hit. But that's not what we're trying to get done. But I am proud of him. We had George Helani in the backfield. We got two true freshmen back there. They're playing their hearts out right now. We just got to clean some things up as coaches and do a better job for them.
Future looks bright. Congrats. Enjoy the win.
Hey, thank you. Go Broncos.
I think well said. That is an issue for this Boise State team to get cleaned up. That kid has taken some big hits 2 weeks in a row. And even though he has stood in there and made a lot of plays, that has to end at some point. for the Broncos to have the kind of year that they want to have. Hank Bachmeier and the Boise State Broncos escape at home with a win against a very tough Marshall team. Final score 14-7 for Jim Mora, for Paul Carcaterra, for Scott Matthews, our producer, Anthony DeMarco, our director, our whole crew. Dave Fleming saying so long from the Blue Turf in Boise. Coming up next, NFL Live. Broncos win 14-7.